Here's the issue, and I'm going to tell you something you already know. It's that you're five games out. No National League Easter team is going to be good enough to win a wild card spot. We don't think, you know, based on the way the Dodgers, Giants, and the Padres are record wise right now from a wild card standpoint. You've got a series against, you know, the best pitchers you're going to face for the rest of this season, and the Atlanta Braves are playing the Baltimore Orioles. They haven't won a game in a month. So the fear right now is, what are the Mets going to do to avoid waking up Monday morning 8 games out of first place with 40 games to go? So how do you address that with the guys, and is that something that you do actively talk about going into the series?
Yeah, we talk and we connect individually and as a group, and I you know, my biggest thing is to control what we can control, right? And we're here in LA. We're not in Baltimore and Atlanta or Philly. Like, we're not in any of those places, and we're here, and this is what we can control. We're playing this game tonight, and I want everyone's energy focus here. And so working together, staying here, being realistic, I mean, that's the biggest thing, because, you know, still with the belief, with the trust, I know I mentioned that a few times, and we mentioned it all throughout the season. That's good. That's going to connect everyone here, but being realistic is what's going to make us just be more on point on what we need to get better. So just staying present, I think, is the biggest thing for us. We're here. We need to stay together. We need to keep working hard, and we need to take care of our games. That's it. Take care of our games. Everything else is going to be taking care of their own. And then when we meet the Phillies or when we meet the Braves, you know, wherever we need to beat for probably gain ground directly, then we'll do that. But right now, we just got to take care of our games.
Is there a feeling that you can, that's tangible for you in the dugout, that if you go down a run or two, it feels like that's it, game's over? Has that feeling gotten into the clubhouse or the dugout yet?
That happened one game, I'm going to say. We're playing one game in Miami, and I felt it. And we did talk about that in the middle of the game and the next day.
You did?
There was a quiet moment. There's a moment of silence there, and I personally didn't like it. I mean, that's not us, and you know, the guys have never done it. So then, you know, they're only human. So there's going to be some emotions at times, and we just got to pick each other up. I mean, that's a team. So it doesn't happen right now. Everyone's rooting. Everyone thinks, you know, we're in the game. Like the game in San Francisco, we were down to that last inning against McGee, and we came back, we tied it, and then we won it in extra. It's like, yep, the guys always feel the cheer for each other, like we're going to come back and win the game. So it really hasn't changed. I mean, we had that one game, and we talked about it. It was fine. It's never happened back.
Talking to Luis Rojas a few more moments. They're out in L.A., of course. Carrasco's pitching tonight against Walker Buehler, who's been damn good this year. And then, you know, you talk about the rest of the pitching matchups. You know, they certainly favor the Dodgers on paper. Last night, it looked like J.D. Davis was pissed at Pete Alonso for the he makes a great stab on the ball. It's a bad throw for sure, about 5-6 feet up the line. And Pete wasn't able to get his body behind it. And, you know, it went to the wall and, you know, bounced right back. But J.D. Davis seemed pissed at Pete. Anything go on between those guys in the dugout or in the clubhouse after the game regarding that, or no?
Nothing. And I did see it after the game. I didn't see it in game. The reaction that J.D. had. And yeah, it's in-game emotions. You know, maybe he thought that Pete should have blocked the ball and maybe keep it in front of him. But, I mean, still, an offline bounce throw, like, that's a tough throw still to handle for Pete. And, you know, JD's just got to be accountable there. He made a nice stop. I know he tried to make the play, and, you know, textbook for the first baseman to knock it down, but just be accountable. You know, probably you should have saved the
he probably
the ball,
he probably but, shouldn't have made the throw, but what, you know, it was a bad throw, and I'm sure he was frustrated by the throw, and he was hoping Pete would bail him out by just body blocking it. But he obviously, as you've seen the video, was like, Pete, what the F, right?
Yeah, it's just human emotion in the middle of the game. He's been playing really good third base for us, and I'm sure he's proud of what he's done, and then he makes that play, and then it turns into an error. So yeah. I think it's just an immediate reaction that, you know, it just caused him to make a mistake, and he became public.
You said last night, and I'm going to read the quote, these things can build up sometimes and can destroy a team. And I don't know the context of it. What were you speaking about in that quote?
Yeah, I was just answering a question, if I can recall. You know, they were talking about the stretches and how can a stretch like this can be detrimental for a team. So I was.
Oh, just, like a losing streak. I got you.
Yeah, and I was just agreeing with the statement because he could. you know, and, you know, good teams prevent that. They stick together through it. So that was my answer to that question.